Thank you. be belongs.
It to be belongs to Him.
Give God your best praise right now. He's ready. Come on, let's get your best. Come on, give me your best. Give me the best. There will be people that know hymns like I do. I'm not going to sing it, but the word that was written said, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He bought me and sought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ever I knew Him, and all I love is through Him. He crushed me in victory. We need His cleansing. How many know you have victory in this place today? I didn't say you feel like they are, but I said, do you know you have? Look at me with my hands and say, feelings change. But knowledge is constant. I have the victory. Give God your best praise one more time. Be in your presence one more time. Lord, thank you. And while we were away from rest, when we weren't on vacation, we had an opportunity to hear from you, to establish some things, Lord, that's coming up very important for this year, and I'm so thankful. Thank you for 2020, where we're seeing you clearly. Thank you for keeping the saints safe and providing for our protection and blessing us, Lord, while you were apart. Now, Lord, we're ready to hear your word. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light into our path. Your word gives us victory, and we have full assurance that we walk in that victory every day. So, Father, let us hear your word like never before today. How does your servant beyond the cross, and Lord, all of you be seen and heard, and not me. I promise you, Lord, I promise you, I'm not going to touch your glory, nor will I touch your praise. When you're done, I'm done, and you'll get the glory out of it, not just from me, Lord God, the word coming, but on our young adults level, where they get the word as well. Minister to them and let them hear your voice and obey it completely. And Lord, for this I say thank you. In Jesus' name. Hold your mouth, everybody. Say, Lord, I thank you that I have a Bible. It is my personal copy. My basic instruction before leaving earth. I am a believer, not a doubter. I'm not just a hearer, but I'm also a doer. And my life is so much better because of the word of the living God. Therefore, I declare, my mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will not be distracted. I will hear the word today. And as a result of what I hear today, somebody say, a lot of pride, I'm going to leave here better than I came here. In Jesus. Young adults, as you go, young man, God, be blessed. Let us fill in where they leave, amen. I probably have to bite you. Amen. If we can just move up a little bit for me if you're sitting way back, I appreciate you. Amen. You're ready for the word.
Yeah.
Beloved, the enemy seeks to complicate the things of God and the things pertaining to God. Can I say that again? The enemy seeks to complicate, make difficult the things of God. Why don't you say that? No, no, no. I mean, now, have I been so long away from you?
Nope.
The enemy seeks to complicate the things of God and make you sit down before you should. He seeks to complicate the things of God and the things that are pertaining to God. And I've come to understand in my walk with God that the more drudgery my perception has been led to think, the more drudgery that there is about the things of God, the less I want to serve. Can I get a witness? The more drudgery that it appears to be, when I say drudgery, I'm talking about it's such a big issue. It's such a big sacrifice. Doing what God told me to do, giving to God's house, participating in the things of God, it is such a hard thing. How many know the more you see it as a drudgery, the less you'll do it?
Yeah. Amen.
The more you see it as something unnecessary, the less you'll find it necessary. So that's why we got a whole bunch of people not living for God, let alone not coming to church. You know, that's a whole different subject. You know, I worked all week and, you know, I'm tired and, you know, and God, you know, I'll get the word and I ain't kicking and screaming, you know, I ain't sometimes screaming necessarily when you're sick and shut in and infirm. Well, I have to work and they make you work. You should be able to get the word. But when you're able-bodied and you should be in the house of God, it's just my opinion. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But it's something about the desire for the things of God that the enemy wants to make you think is so meaningless today. I want to expose and then eradicate this lie of the devil today, because it is a lie. I'm going to say it again, it is a lie. I don't need God, I don't need the things of God. God's word, God's desire, God's work is so insignificant. I can prioritize it differently today because times have changed. But I want us today to hear the power of simplicity. I need you to look at the neighbor and say, neighbor, serving God is simple.
Serving God is simple.
Doing the things of God is simple. And I will no longer allow the enemy to complicate matters.
Regarding to God.
I want to talk from the power of simplicity. You may be seated and expect to hear from God today. There's a little graphic I asked the chronicler to use, and I want to kind of put it up. It's kind of funny to me. And I want to use this graphic if we can get it up there. I mean, it's a graphic taken from Jesus dealing with the two fish and the five loaves. Y'all see that? Everybody see that? Now, we get ready to complicate a miracle, because with this graphic, what did Jesus do? Took what? Two fish, five loaves, and fed over 5,000 people. But if you want to do that miracle today, also what? We're going to have several people say the following. I can't eat that. I'm a vegan. Statement from me before we read the scripture. And I want y'all to grab it real good. And I want you to tell somebody, God dwells in the simple. Isn't that profound? God dwells in the simple. We're the ones that mess up because we complicate everything. God dwells in the simple. Can I prove it to you by the scripture? With that graphic one more time. Now, I just want us to get this. I mean, I just want us to hear by our imagination. You know, this graphic of the two fish and five loaves. One more time. Come on, can we just see it one more time? I mean, here Jesus doing one of the most notable miracles of his ministry here on earth. And folk up here finding fault with the simple. Two fish, five loaves, like breadsticks, little boy's lunch. How complicated can that be? The miracle was taking two fish and five loaves and feeding 5,000 plus people. Here we are in our day and time, want to pick it apart. Pick it apart. God dwells in the simple. So let's look at this text in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 25 to 29. I got your attention. I ain't done yet. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 25 to 29. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than men, and the weakness of God is stronger than men. For you see your calling, brethren, how that not many wise men after the flesh, not many mighty men, not many noble are called. But God has what? Chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty, and the base things of the world and things which are despised have God chosen, yea, the things which are not, to bring to naught things at all, that no flesh should glory in his presence. As complicated as God is to the human mind, he used types and shadows to show us who he is, how to serve him, how to please him. But we complicate him in the examples he gives. We complicate a simple thing like a Passover lamb. Complicate a simple thing that was done in the Old Testament of the priest laying hands on a goat and losing the goat in the wilderness. And how Jesus now says, that's how I separate your sins from you. Far as the east is from the west. Just like that goat took your sins and got lost, God don't remember our sins.
Come on, Bishop.
Amen. But then we complicate matters with not forgiving people that God forgives.
Say it. Amen.
Gotta be fruit inspectors. You know, God may forgive you, but I don't know. You gotta prove me. You gotta come by me. Complicated. Can I go deeper? 1 John chapter 5, verse 1 to 3. Y'all got y'all right? Mm-hmm. Whosoever, verse 1 out of 1 John 5, believeth that Jesus is the Christ, is born of God. Somebody said it's simple. And everyone that loveth him that begat, loveth him also that is begotten of him. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and keep his commandments. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. His commandments, his word, his direction, his instructions are not grievous. Can we go deeper? God has never made following him complicated.
Amen.
It's almost laughable. From the Old Testament to the New, God said, keep my laws, keep my commandments. And we only got in trouble with God when we did not. Keep his laws, keep his commandments. God said, thou shalt never know the God before me. And here they go, the first chance they got, bowing down to a golden calf. Kill, thou shalt not steal. These were not suggestions. These were the simple commandments that God gave. My God, in order for us to walk with him, serve him, love him. And he's not standing over us with a mallet ready to bop you up the other side of your head if you don't do it.
Come on.
And he even made those 10 simple. They didn't disappear. They became more simple. We're going to read it in a minute. But I just want us to understand that the things of God are not complicated.
Amen.
What makes things complicated is the unwillingness to surrender all to God. That's when stuff starts getting messed up. I'm not saying I'm going to get you messed up. We hold on to sin. We hold on to the works of the flesh. We hold on to self. And continue embracing this misconception. It's so hard to serve God. Some of these songs that folk call gospel cannot make a statement in gospel.
Come on, Bishop.
Anybody ever heard the song, "It's So Hard to Get Along"? It's so hard to get along. So you're like, what song is that? Let me give y'all one, you know. How climb it up.
On the rough side.
People get happy on this. That's my jam, boy. That's my jam. And we're like, all these lies that come out of a warped human experience. I'm supposed to make me want to serve God. Here's one. It's kind of borderline. Father in all will know all about it. Father in all will understand why. Cheer my brother, live in the sunshine. We'll understand it by and by. How do you handle people that need to know now? Keep serving God, you'll understand it better by and by. I mean, yeah, there are some things we won't know now, but God does not tell us don't ask him why. God does not tell us don't ask him what's the deal or what's going on with this. He may not answer you the way you want to hear it, but he will answer. We complicate God. He's sitting there shaking his head. Saying, "Will y'all please get out of my way? I never said that. I never said some of the stuff that y'all saying about me. But you have been complicating me so that people that are really seeking me can't find me because I feel to them that I am so distant." So I want to use a few general things that are accepted by folk. Y'all not allow me to take my time. We're going to get out of here early today. I know we're not coming today. You know, I've gotten over it because my future is bright now. I've seen it.
Amen.
Not just leaving it at that. Heard people were waiting for me last week to give me a box of tissue and all this kind of stuff. And I'm like, man, life go on. I told y'all I don't get a check. So we ain't gonna sit up here and be depressed about not praying today.
Yeah.
Half of y'all wouldn't be interested anyway because you don't know what's going on.
Yeah.
You hear everybody else cheering and then you start cheering. But thank God for those that are becoming more knowledgeable.
Amen.
But you know, I want y'all to hear this. Because I'm gonna use a few object scriptures on what we have generally, you know, accepted as I'm doing these things. So I'm pleasing God. Now again, I want to emphasize that God is not into works like we are.
Amen.
He's more about a relationship with God. I work because I love Him. I work because I have a relationship with Him. I don't work to get a relationship. I'm not religious trying to please Him on my terms. I am in a relationship. And because I'm in a relationship, I worship Him. I don't worship Him to get Him to be pleased. I worship Him because I know He is pleased. Isn't that good news? So let me use just five areas, real simple, to show the simplicity of all this serving God, just five things. Can y'all stay with me for a few moments? Somebody say it's simple.
Simple.
Now look at another neighbor across the church and say, God dwells in the simple.
God dwells.
Talk about salvation and being saved. Boy, we've complicated that. Salvation and being saved. Are you baptized in Jesus' name? Are you baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost? Are you going to a Pentecostal church? Are you going to a Baptist church? Are you going to this place? Are you going to that place? You ain't saved if you're Baptist. You ain't saved, my God, in the fullness of God, if you're Presbyterian. You don't love God if you're not speaking in tongues. You're not serving God if you're not dancing five times a worship. Unless you fell on the floor, you really don't know Jesus. All is stupid. But let's see the simplicity of salvation. Look at Acts chapter 1, verse 7 and 8. Somebody say, this simple. Come on, y'all with me. Acts chapter 1, verse 7 and 8. The Bible says the following thing. And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father has put in his own power. But ye shall receive. But ye shall receive. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Hear the text. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. What's complicated about that? Ye shall receive power. Power to dance up and down the aisle?
No.
Power to be religious? Power to be mean and nasty looking and never smile again. Power to judge people. Power to accuse people. Or simply power to become a witness. What is a witness? A first-hand teller of what I saw, of what I heard, about what I've experienced. Guess what? Folk can dispute your religion, but they can't dispute your experience.
Come on,
Bishop.
No, they can't.
You can argue religion all day long, but you can't argue experience. Now, I know some people got some crazy experience. I saw Bigfoot walking here about less than 5 minutes ago. Bigfoot got on a brown sweater and a bald head. I saw Bigfoot. That's the experience. Don't turn around, you might see him too. Now, if you didn't see him, you want to think I'm what?
Crazy.
Don't be afraid to say that. Right?
Crazy.
If I saw Bigfoot walking here, I mean, you got on a size 22 shoe. Come up in here, 9 feet tall, hairy all over, looking like my God, getting bathed in weeds, fur all matted, standing 5 miles away. I saw Bigfoot. You can't tell me I didn't see it. So I'm a witness. Now, proof will validate my witness. But I'm not going to argue and tell you what you didn't see.
the sign just because I didn't see it. I'm going to check it out. So I'm going to stay here long enough. And I'm going to keep looking back there. If I got to leave, I'm going to put up a hidden camera. Because somebody said they saw
Bigfoot.
Well, let's go. We ain't got to go through that with receiving power. Because millions of people before we got here received power. Amen. And the power is why we're sitting here today. Amen. We are worshiping God today because we heard what somebody saw. We heard what somebody experienced. And what did we do? Try it for ourselves. And saw they were telling the truth. I may have had your experience, but I had my own experience. And nobody could argue with me about what I saw.
Amen.
But I heard. Yeah. Come on, let's go deeper. What happened to me?
Yeah.
Another scripture about salvation. Romans 10, 8 to 10. Man, this is a good word. I'm enjoying this. Romans chapter 10, 8 to 10. The Apostle Paul was so eloquent in this. He said, but what saith it? Verse 8. The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Salvation formula, why? It is so simple. So simple. We complicate it. I've heard people tell somebody, you ain't saved. You ain't saved. We've run many people away from God because they weren't saved according to our formula.
Come on, Bishop.
But there's only one formula. Confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart and receive the power. Why do I need to receive the power if I confess with my heart, my mouth, or believe in my heart? Well, beloved, God gave an object lesson that when he made Adam out of the clay by the river Euphrates, out of the dust of the ground, he formed Adam, and Adam was like a mannequin, couldn't move, couldn't do anything, until what? God bent down and breathed into Adam the breath of life. Became a living soul. My God, when you receive the power of God, he brings into you to make your confession worth it, to make your belief validated. His power is now working on the inside to make me a witness.
Amen.
So I need the Holy Spirit to give me power to be a witness. Because otherwise, I would just be a form walking around full of religion, but religion won't change you. 5 Hail Marys won't make you right with God. 16 Our Fathers will not make you right with God. My God, bringing, my God, your last penny to the church won't make you right with God. But he said, confess with your mouth, believe in your heart, and receive the power. Somebody say this simple.
It's simple.
Can I go deeper?
Yes.
Let's talk about holy living. Holy living. Oh, that's a bit. I can't laugh. I can't smile. And we got that spirit. What's that dear name? Oh God, Barry Manilow. Can't smile without you. Some of us get saved and we forget that even God had listened to you. If you don't believe it, look in the mirror. God's matter? Does God's matter?
Yeah.
And it's simpler to smile than it is a frown.
Yes, it is.
More muscles are used physiologically when you frown than they are when you smile.
Yeah.
Come on, medical people.
Yeah.
So God, He shows us again. We complicated living on. Man, if I walk on and step on a crack, my mother broke her back. Don't get this wrong. God, I told a lie a few minutes ago. I didn't mean it. Oh, look out. Then we feel condemned. Feel like the Lord, man, you should feel convicted. Because conviction changes you.
That's right.
But condemnation didn't do you. Yeah. Tell a lie. Have short counsel with God and ask Him to forgive you. And empower you not to lie again. People, I only lie when I sleep. Holy living. Look at Matthew 22. Don't we go on here. 37 to 39. Talk about holy living. Somebody say, holy living.
Holy.
We already talked about salvation simple. Let me show you how simple holy living is. Matthew 22, 37 to 39. Then I got a graphic to show you all of that. Matthew says, Jesus said unto them, the words of Jesus, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy
soul,
and with all thy
mind.
This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor. Explain this. Somebody say, holy living.
Holy living.
Now, there are 613 or so laws that the Jewish people keep. Nothing wrong with it. This is covenant law. We shouldn't throw them out. We should observe them, but we observe them because they lead to something greater than just keeping the law. The law by itself, the Bible says to let him kill it, but the Spirit gives life. I don't want to just follow a law and not have what the law needs me to. Because if it's all about the law, I get caught up on religion instead of on relationship. Lord, did I pray enough? Lord, did I speak in tongues enough? Lord, did I fast enough? Lord, did I say hallelujah enough? God, not counting. How many times you pray? You don't care if you bow to the east or stand up and face the north. God is not concerned. My God, He asks the Jews to face the temple when they pray, only to train them to let the temple be them, because the Bible said we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. So when I can't make it to a building, I can still worship. Y'all not talking to me.
Yes.
So, 613 laws, they're not obsolete. But God simplified. Somebody say He simplified.
Simplified.
I want to make sure y'all hear this. He didn't throw them away. He simplified. And some of y'all be in trouble. Crab cake last night. Don't look at me like that. Listen, you're talking about can't eat crab cake. No. No. But that ain't really what concerns God. Yeah, crab cakes can bother you. Eat too much of them.
Yeah.
Cholesterol build up. Heart attack. Stroke.
Yeah.
Come on. Yeah. Ham. God knows. Unless you cook pork right, you'll get all the big eight.
Right.
Y'all not talking to me.
Come on, Bishop.
You have to cook pork at a higher temperature,
yeah,
than any other meat, so you can kill off the pesticides. Y'all know I'm telling the truth.
Amen.
Those
That's true.
You lay still long enough.
Look,
there's
two tubes.
Crabs are scavengers.
Yep, they eat anything.
Lobsters, scavengers. Mm-hmm. Some of y'all are like, oh God, what can I eat? God is not trying to stand over your head, because y'all remember that sheep let down in the New Testament. God was giving an object lesson to Peter. He said, don't call unclean what I sanctify. When he told Peter, rise, come to me. Because there was a Gentile standing out the gate wanting to be saved. Come to my house. So God had to tell Peter, I know the custom said, don't you as a Jew go in the Gentile's house. But that Gentile want to be saved. I want you to get him saved. I don't care if he was born a Gentile. I see the soul, because there is no Gentile soul. There is no Jewish soul. There is no black soul. There is no white soul. There is no Hindu soul. There is no Muslim soul. God says in the King Ezekiel, all souls are mine.
Amen, amen.
And here we are. Got this stuff. Again, the 613. Are not obsolete. Jesus simply simplified.
Amen.
Said, you want to live holy? Love the Lord your God with all. Let's take the context. Why did he say this? Because somebody asked him, what can I do to be saved? Mm-hmm. Somebody asked him, what can I do to be accepted? What did Jesus say?
Love the Lord.
Love the Lord. With all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. Then when he said, you can't just love the Lord, love yourself. You got to love your
neighbor
as yourself. That's another part of living holy. A lot of us don't do. We treat each other like dirt and expect God to give us. No, sir. No, sir. You got to treat for
right.
You got to take care of your relationship with folk. You can't walk around without right living. Not only inwardly, horizontally also. Not just vertically me and God, but horizontally me and my brother. That's why Jesus died on a cross. Had the vertical part right. But he stretched that wide for the horizontal. God have mercy.
Amen.
So God's word is our guide to living. Somebody look at me and say, not suggestions.
Not suggestions.
Not wise counsel.
Not wise counsel.
No, no, no. We live holy simply by doing what he said.
That's right. Amen.
He said, look at your neighbor's wife to lust.
Amen.
Come on, y'all should be preaching with me. Don't be lusting after your neighbor's wife.
That's right.
He said, don't steal.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. Don't kill.
Don't commit murder.
Amen.
Don't kill. And we have been complicated. But Lord, she was fine. But she ain't mine. I don't care how much you and Mrs. Jones got a thing going on. Mrs. Jones belongs to
Mr. Jones.
Your name is Scrimmer Scrim. You want your own Mrs. Scrimmer Scrim. Simply, you have power to be a witness. How to keep you from breaking the word of God. We complicate things when we don't let the power empower us.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Can I go deep?
Yes.
Y'all all right?
Yes.
Number three, told you this simple. I'm almost done. Let's talk about soul winning and discipleship. Show me my little graphic from people.
Love people.
Love yourself.
Love yourself.
Tell about that simple.
That's simple.
Even Randy can understand. That's big for you. Love God. Then what do we all need? Love people. Love yourself. If you ain't gonna do it to yourself, don't do that to nobody else.
Right, right, right.
Simple. You ain't gonna talk to yourself like that. How many of y'all getting there? You, I hate you. Your mama. You looking in the mirror.
Whoa.
You cuss yourself out. I ain't do nothing to me. Come on, people.
Amen.
Love God. Love people. Love yourself. Let's go to the third scripture. Almost done. Go to Mark 16, 15 and 16. Y'all getting some out of this?
Yeah.
Simple. Let's talk about soul winning and being disciples. Do more because. Mark 16, 15, 16, the Bible says, and he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be
saved.
But he that believeth not shall be
damned.
Y'all gonna say it ain't a bad word.
Okay.
Damned. It means doomed. It means convicted and found guilty. Let's also look at Acts 1:8. Again, but ye shall receive power. After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. Look at my little graphic. Look at my little graphic. I got another one for you. Y'all like my little pictures? Come on, proper, help me out. Talking about discipleship. And yeah. God didn't call you to win arguments. Called you to win souls. Y'all see how some of us are. I gotta show that heathen. I gotta prove I'm wrong. God knows. And then you get so mad you cuss. You go to hell. Know you first. After your mama. Man, you done got them mad at you. And you mad at them. If any of you out cold makes me lose a soul, then I need to let that view go.
Amen.
Follow me. You don't say anything but what God said. So don't be saying, well, Bishop, I'm going to a gay marriage because I don't want to lose a soul. No. God condemns that action, not the person.
Amen.
The action.
Amen.
But how can I show them I love them unless I attend their wedding? You show them you love them by saying, I don't agree with what you're doing.
Amen.
Disagreement is not hate.
Amen.
Come on. I don't agree. Because what I put my presence in, I'm giving my okay. If I'm giving my presence to this, I'm saying it's okay.
That's right.
God didn't say it's okay. So until God said, but what about love? That's how gays have hijacked this thing. God never said, I don't love you.
Come on, that's right.
God will stand there and say, depart from me. I never knew you with tears in his eyes. He loves you, but he can't accept what you do. We have complicated matters because we are now putting the gay flag next to the name of our church.
Come on, Bishop.
And the Lord calls a church to help people change. So you may not be gay, but you may be a robber. You need to change. You may not be a robber, but you're beating your wife. You need to change. So y'all not saying amen now. My God, whatever. You may be cheating on your income taxes. You need
change.
Sin is sin in the eyes of God.
That's right.
A Said sin is sin in the eyes of God. But what makes gays such a horrible thing? Because gays are the only ones asking for acceptance. I haven't seen the murderer march on Washington.
Come on, Bishop.
Y'all know I'm not talking. I mean, it might be kind of funny. But half the murderers I'm going to try to hide. I'm sorry. No irreverence needed. But I don't see the murderers with the flag saying celebrate Murderers Day. I don't see thieves saying, I got your TV, how you like me now? Give me my day. Only reason why Cain get the attention it gets with opposition is because you take that which is private and try to make it acceptable publicly. And there are some people that will never, they may not be saved, but they will never accept that because that is not the natural word of God. But God made me that way. No, he didn't. We were made when we come. We were born in sin, shaped in iniquity. I have the capacity to be gay. I can sin any sin I want to sin. I can kill you right now. I can steal your car. I have the capacity, and you got it too, to go against God. If I do that, I'm complicating things. God spoke about it. God spoke how he felt about it. I complicated what I try to say, what I feel. So what do we do? I've come to this understanding that if God says something, all heaven will help me keep it.
Come on, Bishop.
Amen.
All heaven will help me become it. I got the ease of the presence and the power of God to help me get it done. That'll be a good place to preach right there. Y'all still sitting there? But what about love? What about love? Love will help you to do what discipleship is really about.
Amen.
It is. Tell people what God did for you on a consistent basis. And after you finish talking, show them how to do it.
That's right. Amen. That's right.
That's discipleship.
Yeah.
Discipleship is not just Bible class, not just Sunday school, not just new members class. Discipleship is me living the life in front of you, showing you that by the power of God, you can live it too. Making myself available to show you the same God that saved me. The same God that healed me. The same God that delivered me. I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply staying within. I was seeking right to rise no more in discipleship, but I heard the master of the sea. He heard my despairing cry from the water, lifted me, and I said, "For now." And guess who else he's lifting?
Amen. Amen.
Discipleship is good. Follow me. That's the follow Christ. The Bible says we shall be witnesses. You can't witness to somebody about the power of God to change you if you're not letting God change you. I lost some of y'all. I think I lost Bigfoot. Number four. Come on. Let's talk about giving and tithing. Where's the pen? Somebody needs to drop. Some of you say, here you come.
Here you go.
Talk about that moment. Mm-hmm. It's simple though.
Amen.
Luke 6:38. Given it shall be.
Given unto you.
Given it shall be.
Given unto you.
I had one witness say it loud. Where they go? Give it and shall be. Messing with you, lady. Good measure. Press down. Shake it together. Right. Did I actually teach this scripture properly? Does it say keep it? And it shall be given unto you?
Yes.
What's the operative word in this text?
Yeah.
Oh, God. And shake it together and run it over. Shall men do what?
Give unto your bosom.
Oh, Nelly. Give it and shall be given unto you. Good measure. Press down. Shake it together. Run it over. Shall men give it to your bosom. Here it is. For with the same measure that you meet it out with all, it shall be measured to you again. Close hand don't give.
That's right.
And a close hand won't receive.
That's right.
Here's another one. Malachi 3:10. Somebody say it simple.
Simple.
Bring you all the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house. Prove me now, amen. God said, what? Prove me. Saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there be not room to receive it. When it comes to tithing and giving, simply obey God.
Amen.
I mean, we got all the people coming. Tithing in for today. God don't want 10%. What God want with our money? Blah, 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 blah. There's nothing about giving that doesn't cause a blessing.
Amen.
I'm going to say it again. There's nothing about giving that doesn't cause a blessing. And you got everybody fighting giving. You need to start telling people, stop fighting my blessing. Just like that commercial. Stop messing with my discount. Some of you need to look at people and say, stop messing with my blessing. A closed hand doesn't give, but a closed hand will not receive. God can do more with what you give him than God can allow you to do with what you keep from him. Your money, God gave it to you. Why should I not make it available to you?
Amen.
I can't mention the names. But God does stuff like you sitting at home, mind your business, and because you're a giver, folk call you, offer you a job, and you weren't even looking for one.
Amen.
I know what I'm talking about. You're writing books, and folk calling you wanting to make movies out your books. You do what God told you to do, and God has shown you what he can do with the little bit you give him. Your money will never meet all the needs that heaven has, and heaven has no need. But when you put that in the hands of God, he'll stretch it, he'll bless you, he'll open up the windows of heaven and show you what I can do.
Amen. Yes, he
will. With a dollar sign, it's an unlimited return when you obey God.
Yes,
God will bless you in ways that are beyond the dollar.
That's right. Yeah.
No,
that's right.
Yes.
Anybody ever owed a bill? Give it up. And somebody wrote you and said, give me half of what you owe me. Mm-hmm. Your account's settled.
Uh-huh.
That's called settlement.
Yeah.
Anybody ever had a settlement letter?
Yeah.
Amen.
Y'all
amen.
Yeah. Send it, look at it.
Mm-hmm.
Beloved, guess what God ready to do? Settle your accounts. God has not said he's ready to settle your accounts. If you simply have a mind to stop complicating. Why is money such an issue, Mike? Why have people got issues? I ain't talking about you. You wore your Oreo shirt today because you're a giver. Why do people take what God simply says give? Yeah. Some people worry about God trying to get it from you. You should be praising him for what he's trying to get to.
Amen.
Amen.
He never asks with a take mentality. He asks with a give mentality.
Amen.
What does scripture say? The same measure you
give,
you'll
receive.
So when I give, I'm happy.
Amen.
How are y'all like receiving?
Amen.
Amen.
I'm just humble at the feet of Jesus. I don't like receiving. I'm not worthy. The devil is alive. Ross, 50,000 rings. How would you have? Well, I'm just a humble servant of God. I have no idea what I'm going to do with another $50,000. So it's why I'll be taking this place up.
Amen.
You don't realize I just gave you a prophetic word.
Amen.
See, y'all sitting there. Y'all be praising God, say, don't forget about me. Can I real quick tell y'all, first worship, I know brother not here today, shame on you. Gave a brother a word of knowledge, some of y'all heard that. About a promotion, don't turn it down. Within 5 days after the Lord told me to tell him, boss called him in the job, offered him a promotion. He thought about turning it down, but he remembered what I said. Don't turn it down. He called me the next day and said, Bishop, man, what's going on? God did what you said. I said, God, give me praise.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. Amen.
Some of us, when you have been a giver, some of you miss it. God is trying to get something to you.
Yes.
That's right.
So all givers ought to be praising God right now because of what God's trying to get to you. He's not trying to take. Last but not least, I'm done. Y'all all right?
Amen.
Yeah.
It's been a good word.
Yeah.
Let's talk about participating in a community of believers. Look at Hebrews chapter 10, verse 22, 25. Oh, I don't want to be around the church. I mean, I just saw on Sunday. I don't need to go be around him. Shucks. Hebrews 10:22 says, let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast. That's the idea of grace. Holding tight. Let us hold fast with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast the profession of our faith without wavering, for he is faithful to promise. And let us consider one another to provoke unto good love and good works. Not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as a manner of some is, but exhorting one another, and so much more as you see the day approaching. I ain't got to spend a lot of time on this. This world is getting evil, and more evil by the day.
Yes, it is.
We can shake our heads and stay indoors. We can gather with the saints, be encouraged and empowered to change our world.
Amen.
The Bible says iron
sharp as iron.
I can't be sharpened from a distance. Simple. God said don't forsake the assembly. He has a reason. He wants to bless us corporately, to encourage us individually, so that we can corporately see the blessing. Can I say it in the beginning? He wants to bless us corporately in order to encourage us individually so we can corporately see the blessing. I'm closing, but it's a blessing to me when somebody walk up in here and testify what God has done. I don't get jealous. I get hopeful. Shake my fist and say, that's my blessing. But I rejoice with them because I know I'm next in line.
Amen.
Raise your hands if you've ever been encouraged by what somebody else got.
Amen.
If you've ever been blessed by somebody else's blessing. If you know good and well, you've been fighting a long time and asking God, win, 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 win. somebody coming in and say, God did it, my God. And you said, I just prayed with them. I just worshiped with them. I just gave God glory with them. I'm holding on with them. Surely, Lord, you see me. And God is not unrighteous to forget you. And we praise God now for somebody else because God is ready to bless us too. So as I close, there's no need to add to what God said. There's no need to take away from God's sin. Here's one of my words, y'all. There's no need to philosophize.
Amen.
What God said, just do it. Mm-hmm. His words are not grievous. He's not trying to take something from you. He's trying to bring something to you. So serve him. Be involved in his work. Treat people right. Be saved and full of the Holy Spirit. Matter of fact, it's so simple to receive, just ask him. Stop complicating the things of God. I'm done. Because everything God says is doable.
Amen. Amen.
I said everything. Amen. God says is doable. And you know why it's doable? Because he helped me to do it.
Amen.
Man, when the worship leader says lift your hands and worship, just do it.
Amen.
I don't feel like lifting my hand. Just lift it. When God says, stand and give me glory, just do it. But my leg hurt. My coins. My dogs is barking. Put a muzzle on them dogs and stand and worship.
Amen.
Matter of fact, let's stand now. And let's lift our hands. Because God's going to prove himself what he said today. Simply worship God. Don't wait for me to tell you what to say. Open your mouth and bless the Lord. There you go, complicated. Don't let Bigfoot praise God more than you. Come on, give God some praise. Some honor. Come on, church.
Thank you, Jesus.
This word is for our church.